Next up, we have Ms. Nadyiah Spencer. She's head of productions and sourcing at SUNO, and she studied English at Spelman College, and she's currently married to Mr. Maurice Spencer. Give it up for Ms. Nadyiah.
Hello, hello, hello. Assalamu alaikum, everybody. I initially was going to go and talk about fashion and where I've been in the world and coming from Plainfield High School and traveling here and there and doing these things, which has been amazing, and I'm a graduate of Cedarbrook School and Hubbard and Plainfield High, went on to Spelman, and my education can rival those who have gone to schools in Scotch Plains, to Red Bank, and here and there, all through New Jersey and the greater area. But ironically enough, on my way over, I was looking through my iPhone, and I looked at something entitled Willie Lynch Syndrome. Ironically enough, today is 300 years to the day that slave owner Willie Lynch made a speech. And let me rewind, people. Willie Lynch was a slave owner who delivered a speech in 1712 in Virginia. He was a slave owner in the West Indies, okay? And he delivered a speech on how to control a slave. And what he did was cause division amongst the people on those plantations. If you were light, you were here. If you were dark, you were there. If you were strong, you were put over here. If you were thin, you were over here. If you were big, you were here. If you were fat, there. He just division right across the board. The field nigger versus the house nigger. The one serving me lemonade versus the one who is mowing the lawn. He put a program in order to make us hate one another. And I look now, and I'm going back to the travel, the Crips and Bloods, East and West, and now in Plainfield. I look at the Incans in Peru. I look at the Ashanti versus this, or what we had in Rwanda originally, not too long ago. There is so much hatred amongst ourselves. And I might be lighter than this brother here, but that doesn't make me better than him. I might be bigger than the sister back there, but that doesn't make me more voluptuous and sexier than her. I am upset and bothered about the violence in our community. And I see my Latin brothers and sisters in the audience. I was recently in Colombia, Lima, Sao Paulo, Brazil. And it's the same where being black in Latin America is not easy either. Being a woman of color in Latin America is not easy either. And I want to talk to the young people about good hair versus bad hair. And I'm prettier than her because my hair is curlier than her. She's prettier than me, mommy, because she's lighter than me. Oh, God, no. Oh, God, no. Look in the mirror, my little babies. And every day, this is what my mother taught me to say to myself, I am beautiful because I'm Nadyiah. Not because Nadyiah might have a skin tone or this, or I might be smarter. Just because I'm Nadyiah. It doesn't mean I'm beautiful because I'm better than her or anyone else. It just says I'm beautiful because I am me. And my young black men, oh, I love you. And I'm sorry, and my young Latin men, I'm sorry that the world is not kind to you. Because I see how they treat you in Europe. I see how they treat you in South Africa. I see how they treat you on the streets of Plainfield. And there was something Farrakhan told me when I was graduating from Spelman maybe 15 years ago, that you have to love yourself more than anybody else does, even if your mother doesn't say it, if your father doesn't say it, your aunt doesn't say it. Because without a belief in yourself, you can't do very much. And no matter what school system gives you, you might have the best textbooks, the best teachers, the best of everything. If you don't have belief in yourself, the best of that means nothing. So I say to all of us today, no matter what your differences are, your weight, your height, your complexion, your hair, whatever, it doesn't matter. It's your heart that matters. It's your heart that matters. So I say, everyone, let's hold hands. And I know this might sound trite and contrived, but that's what it takes. Recently, I'm wrapping up Uncle Buggy. Recently, there was a violence in Kenya, post-election violence. And 5 years ago, over 3,000 people died about different tribes who were voting. This same year, same elections happened, not one person died. Why? Because they held hands. They talked through. They recognized, because I might be Kikuyu or I might be Ashanti doesn't make me better than you. We all have to fight this government and figure out what's best for our people. So that's all I have to say. I am from Plainfield. I love Plainfield. I've lived all around the world, and I came back to Plainfield because Plainfield means something to me. And I'm not going to let thugs run me out of my house. I'm paying too much taxes for that now. So everybody have a great day, and let's keep the peace.